Hey, what's up YouTube? Today I'm going to show you how to play Photograph by a tune, and it's going to sound like this. And skipping on a bit. So you can keep me inside the pocket of your ripped jeans. So first of all though, apologies for like this really like twilight lighting situation going on. I'm doing this tutorial in my dad's shed because like, yeah, my entire family are kind of in my house at the moment and there's just a lot of people and there's just not enough space, and so I'm sorry, woodshed, ghetto lighting, but here we are. Okay, but hopefully you can still see the guitar. Sorry, I'm just kind of looking at the screen to the side. Yeah, hopefully you can still see the guitar, that's the main thing. Okay, so if you want to play along with the track, you're going to need a capo on 4, and you're going to need 4 chords. You've got a C, a G, an A minor, and an F. So if you know how to play those chords, skip ahead, and if you don't, keep watching. So high E string, string 1, low E string, string 6. So to play a C, you're going to put your middle finger on the 2nd string, 1st fret. Your middle finger on the 4th string, 3rd, your middle finger on the 4th string, 2nd fret, and your ring finger on the 5th string, 3rd fret. So to get from a C to an A minor, all you're going to do is just move your ring finger to the 3rd string, 2nd fret. So you've got a C, an A minor. Okay, so to play a G, you're going to put your 1st finger on the 5th string, 2nd fret, your middle finger on the 6th string, 3rd fret, your ring finger on the 2nd string, 3rd fret, and your little finger on the 1st string, 3rd fret. So final chord now is F. So there are two ways you can play F. You can play this full bar version, or this mini bar version. It doesn't really matter which one you play. Mini bar F is easier, but full bar F sounds better, so kind of your choice entirely. Okay, so to play full bar F, what you're going to do is you're going to bar all the strings at the 1st fret with your 1st finger. You're going to put your middle finger on the 3rd string, 2nd fret, your ring finger on the 5th string, 3rd fret, and your little finger on the 4th string, 3rd fret. So that's full bar F. To play mini bar F, you're going to bar the 1st and the 2nd string at the 1st fret with your 1st finger. You're going to put your middle finger on the 3rd string, 2nd fret, and your ring finger on the 4th string, 3rd fret. Sorry, itchy nose in the middle there. Dearie me, it's all this dust in the shed. Not gonna lie, I'm allergic to dust, but here we are. The lengths I go to do YouTube tutorials. But, okay, so you've 4 chords. You've got C, G, A minor, and then F for this version. Okay, so what we're gonna do for this song, there are 2 chord patterns, and obviously the intro. So what I'm gonna do is, first of all, I'm gonna teach you how to play the intro, and then we'll chat about chord patterns and stuff later. The intro sounds like this. Okay, so that's what I'm going to teach you today. So most of that intro is based around the chord shape C. Obviously it kind of changes a few times, but it's all good. So what we're going to do, if you skipped how to play the chords, I'm counting high E string, a string 1, low E string, a string 6. So if you put your fingers in the shape of a C, the deal with this chord pattern, with this this picking pattern even, is it's basically the same apart from the last string you pluck. And the last string you pluck of kind of one block is the first string of the next block of picking, sort of thing. So what I'll do is I'll just show you the first block of picking and then explain how each subsequent block differs. So what you're going to do is, in the shape of a C, you're going to pluck string 5, string 2. You're then going to pull your finger, your first finger off of string 2. So you kind of get this pull-off sound. You're then going to put your finger back on string 2 and then pluck it again. So you've got this like pluck, pull-off, pluck again. So you've got string 3, 2, pull-off, pluck again. So you've got 3, 2, pull-off, 2. After that, you're then going to pluck string 3, then you're going to move your fingers slightly from the C position. So you're going to move your ring finger on to the third fret of the fourth string. So it's basically kind of, your middle finger is here, it's on exactly the same string, just the fret above. So, like I said, after you have the string five, string two, pull off string two, you pluck string three. Then what you're going to do is you're going to do another pull off. So you're going to pluck string four and pull off your ring finger. And then, so you've kind of got, obviously I realise you can't hear it because I'm playing it quite slowly. So you pluck string four, pull off. Then what you're going to do is you're going to put your fingers back in the shape of a C and then pluck string five. So what that means is you're just going to move your ring finger back to where it was. So I realise that's quite a lot to take in. What I'm going to do is I'm just going to go through that a few more times, nice and slow, and then I'll speed it up. Just playing that exactly. So you've got five, two, pull off, two, three, four, pull off, five. One block of picking. So you're going to play that completely as it is. Then the next time you play that block, the one thing that is going to change is going to be the last string that you pluck. So the string stays exactly the same. I lie. Actually, it's just going to be the last note you're playing on that string. So the second time you play that block of picking, the last string you're going to pluck is still the fifth string, but instead of having your ring finger on the third fret, your ring finger, I don't know what it's going to be doing, maybe just like floating in space or whatever, you're not going to have any fingers on the fifth string, okay? It's going to be a completely open string. And then, like I said, because that's the last string of that block, and then the first string of the next block, it just kind of goes on like that. So what I'll do is I'll show you what that will sound like. So from the beginning. As you can tell, the last kind of note that is being played, it was the third fret the first time, then the second time, it's just a completely open fifth string. So what you do is you repeat the open fifth string picking twice, and then the next time you play it, what you're going to do is your last note, instead of being the open fifth string, you're going to move your ring finger down to the third fret on the sixth string. So you're going to play the third fret on the sixth string as your last note. You're going to play that twice. So from the beginning, that's going to sound like. So as you can see, I'm now moving my ring finger to the sixth string of the third fret of the sixth string. I have to say, it's not particularly comfortable, but you do just kind of get used to it. So you play that twice. And then the last block of the picking, you're only going to play this once, which is a good thing, to be honest, because it's really freaking awkward. So, I don't know, maybe there's like a better way of playing it, but this is just kind of the way I've found which works best for me. So what you're going to do, the previous block of picking, you're plucking the sixth string and the third fret. You're going to keep your fingers in the shape of a C, and you're going to bring your thumb around the neck of the guitar and put it on the sixth string at the first fret, okay? So I'll just take it from the one before. So you've now got your finger on the sixth string, third fret. So that, and then it just kind of finishes there, okay? And then it goes straight back into the verse. So I'm gonna try figure out a way of how I can make that easier, like maybe to visualize. I can't decide. What I do, either way, I'll definitely put the link to the tab in the description box. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to play that whole intro for you now. So yeah, just kind of practice it. I'm sorry, it gets a bit awkward towards the end. And then it goes into the verse. Okay, so that is by far the hardest part of the song done. So the next part of the song is just the verse, loving can hurt sometimes. So the chord pattern for this is very simple. You've just got a C, a G, minor, and an F. You're going to hold each of those chords for 8 beats. So you should have a C, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, G, 2, 3, 4, 6, 7, 8, A minor, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and F, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So what you're going to do is the first time in the verse, Ed Sheeran just literally, all he does is he palm mutes and he down strums. So that just sounds like this. So all you're doing is you're palm muting. So that means you're going to put this part of your palm, just rest it lightly on this bit of the strings. So then it gives you this kind of muting sound. Sort of thing. So what you're going to do is you're just going to mute for 8 beats. Just 8 beats in every single chord. Okay, so then you get to the pre-chorus. The chord pattern for the pre-chorus, the pre-chorus is the bit that goes, we keep this love in a photograph. So the chord pattern for the pre-chorus, you've got an A minor, an F, a C, and a G. So this time, instead of holding the chords for 8 beats, you're only going to hold them for 4. So what you can do is you can just palm mute. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Or you can use a strumming pattern. So the strumming pattern I'm going to show you for the pre-chorus, you can also, I kind of do it for the chorus too. So your choice entirely, however you want to do it. The strumming pattern would sound like this. So what that is, that's just down, down, up, up, down, up. Okay. Down, down, up, up, down, up. So one lot of down, down, up, up, down, up equals 4 beats. So you're just going to play one lot of strumming pattern on each chord in the pre-chorus. Slightly different for the chorus, but I'll just tell you now. That's because all the chords in the chorus you're going to hold for 8 beats, so therefore all you're going to do is just play the strumming pattern twice on the chord pattern for the chorus. So the chord pattern for the chorus got C, C, G, G, A minor, it's crazy because the intro, like, I suppose it's not that hard kind of when you get used to it, but at the start you're like, oh my god, like, what is this? But then the rest of the song is like uber easy to play. So what I'm going to do now is I'm just going to show you what all of that, like the entire song, sounds like smushed together. I can't sing it at the pitch that he does, so I'm sorry, the capo is coming off. And yeah, so this is hopefully what it's going to sound like. However it goes. Keep this love in a photograph. We make these memories for ourselves. Where our eyes are never closing, hearts are never broken, times are never frozen still. So you can keep me inside the pocket of your ripped jeans, holding me close until our eyes meet. You won't ever be alone before me to come home. And then it goes on. Okay, so I realised I normally kind of show you what bits sound like at different parts of the tutorial, but it's all good. It's all mushed together. So there we go. So yeah, that's the whole song. So please comment, please rate, please subscribe, please request. So my lesson for the day, it's not a lesson for the day, it's more a, we'll call it a recipe for the day. So I spent my summer working at a summer camp, sorry, hence the sailing swag. I don't really sail, but anyway. I did this summer though. It was fun. I enjoyed it. Only went into irons once. Anyway, but whatever. So the my recipe for the day is for the most beautiful thing you've ever eaten in your life. It's called a doughboy. So what you do is you take, say, like a square of like pizza dough, and in the middle you put like chocolate chips, marshmallows, cinnamon and sugar, kind of, I don't know, jelly worms, whatever you want to put really. And then you wrap this kind of middle up in this dough and form it in a ball. Then what you do is you just wrap it in foil, pop it in the campfire, and then yeah, depending on how long it takes to cook, my god, it is the best thing you have ever had in your life. Like, all the middle melts inside and all the pizza dough cooks, and oh my god, it's just epic. I had at least one doughboy every single week for the summer. So to be honest, I don't really want to even work out for my arteries how much that means I had, but I had a lot. So yeah, so that is my recipe for the day. Let me know if you've had them. They're the best thing ever. Let me know if you have any favorite campfire recipes. I'd love to say I'd try them next year, but I have to do a master's, so I'm sorry. Sadly, this might be the end of my camp counselling career, because, you know, I have to be an adult now. Ugh, anyway, but all good. So yeah, please comment, please rate, please subscribe, and please request, and have a nice life, YouTube.